24 hours as a retired man. How do you feel? The same? Is it any different? How's the last day been for you?
It's been pretty surreal. I just kind of pinch myself. Can't believe that it's over. But at the same time, excited to, you know, just be at home, be with my family, be with my two older boys, and you know, watch them grow up, you know, around the rinks.
Jimmy, there was some reports that Kenny Holland, your old general manager in Detroit, had reached out about the situation in Edmonton. They have some concerns with their goaltending right now through injuries and other issues. Give us the background there. Was that an option? And it seemed like you were pretty comfortable in just being where you are now and just staying at home and calling it a career.
No, Kenny did call. He called 2 weeks ago, and I was like, Kenny, you're a little late to the party. I was like, I'm gonna retire. So, yeah, it was like the beginning of December, and I was out with my goalie coach, and I was skating, and I was just, you know, getting pelted by pucks, and I was like, this isn't fun anymore. Like, you know, it hurts, and, you know, I don't want to get hit by pucks anymore. So I was like, that's probably a good indication that you're probably done playing. And, you know, I haven't touched the ice since then, except for when, you know, coaching the little guys.
Jimmy, I spent a whole career not liking getting hit by the puck, so I can completely relate what you're talking about. I never liked it. So now you played your whole career for the Detroit Red Wings. How much does that mean to you that you spent the whole time, original six, great franchise, great success, but all in one organization?
Just a tremendous honor. You know, you just don't see that anymore. Guys are constantly on the move in this league, you know, especially with the salary cap. But it was an honor, and I cherished every single day that I got to put that wing wheel across my chest. You know, be able to play for an original six team for your whole career, I consider that to be a huge accomplishment, not only for myself, but for anyone that's able to do it.
And do you still watch the Red Wings? Do you watch their games? Is there a hockey fan in you still in terms of following that team and seeing how they're doing?
Yeah, I mean, I still watch the guys. You know, obviously I want them to, you know, have a great, great season. You know, I've still got, you know, a lot of friends on there. And, you know, I wish them nothing but the best, but I don't just watch the Wings. You know, I'm a hockey fan. I love the game. You know, I still love, you know, learning new things and seeing what guys can do. You know, just so gosh darn talented now out there on the ice, these young guys, how they step in and contribute right away. So it's, you know, it's fun to watch, and it's, you know, it's a fun time to be a hockey fan and watching where this, you know, game is, you know, the direction it's going.
You know, I can't help but follow up and ask you about this Texier shootout goal. Did you see this goal last night?
Yeah, that was slick.
Oh my gosh. I mean, as a goaltender, what were you thinking watching that?
I was happy I was sitting on my couch and I wasn't moving. There's been enough highlights on NHL Network with me getting scored on. So I was just happy that, you know, it wasn't me. I've definitely been there. That one will be showing all year.
That's what I figured. That you were happy it wasn't you, right?
Oh, yeah. So thrilled it wasn't me.
Hey, Jimmy, you have lived the dream for a young American kid. You were part of the early days of the U.S. national development team. You played college hockey at the University of Maine. You played a national championship game. You've worn the USA sweater at different tournaments over your career. You played, as Mike talked about, you played for an original six franchise for so long and had such a terrific career. You've seen the position change over time. You know, I'm coaching young kids. I got two goalies, John Fox and Jason Lirico, so I got to give them a shout out. They've been playing well. But what's your message to those young goalies out there that are watching in terms of what they need to do to continue to get better?
I think the main thing, like a lot of people, you know, may not realize, but it comes down to goalies is skating. I think when you're young, you just, you know, you get drawn to the equipment because it looks so cool, and the helmets are, the masks are painted, and it's fun and all, but you really got to be a solid, solid skater. You got to be able to get from point A to point B, and you got to be able to do it quick. So, if you want it, if you, you know, the young goalies out there, you know, constantly working on your edge work is going to be, you know, a big step in the right direction in your development in order to make the big saves out there.
Jimmy, I thought all this time goalies tell me they're the best skaters of the team. They were just full. They're just pumping their own tires. There you are telling me it might actually be true. So we'll keep an eye out for that one. But whenever you have a big moment like this, you step away, you retire, you get a little reflective about what you've gone through and the people that helped you along the way. So where does your mind go when you start thinking about your NHL career, your hockey life, and some of the people that helped you achieve all that you did?
First and foremost, it goes to my parents, my mom and dad, and their selflessness of, you know, driving me around upstate New York and all over Southern Ontario. You know, my dad and I spent a lot of hours in the vehicle together, and it's kind of come full circle. So that's like me and my oldest son, James, now traveling about playing AAA hockey. So, you know, without my mom and my dad and, you know, obviously there are coaches out there that, you know, I wouldn't be in this position if it weren't for them. But, you know, first and foremost, it goes straight back to, you know, my parents and their selflessness to, you know, do whatever it took to, you know, so I was able to play.
Yeah, and that goes back to, you know, before you were Jimmy Howard of the Detroit Red Wings, right. There was little Jimmy Howard going to the rinks
That's
early
right.
as can be, mm-hmm. I'm sure. And now you're doing that, as you mentioned, for your kids. I can see you're decked out, and I believe it's Grizzlies gear.
The Oakland Grizzlies.
So, what, you know, how much joy do you get out of now sort of taking over that role and seeing that come full circle, and now you're helping your kids, you know, play the game that they love, and you kind of get to experience the game from a really different standpoint?
I love it. I mean, yeah, I mean, as soon as this Zoom call's over, me and Henry got a jet to hockey practice. So, but I love it. It's kind of built, for me, it's kind of filled that void of, you know, hockey with them, you know, and their schedules. I'm at the rink, you know, 5-7 times a week. So, you know, hockey is still, you know, a higher priority in my life, and that's where I want it to be. But I love coaching these kids just because it's the game that I love. I love, you know, teaching it to them. I love seeing, you know, the light bulb go off in their minds when you've been, you know, trying to teach them something out on the ice, and they just like, oh, I got it. Now I get a, you know, good sense of fulfillment, you know, sharing my knowledge for the game and my love for the game for all these young kids.
Well, it sounds like you're not going to have to spend any time wondering what you're going to do with all of your time now that you are retired. But congratulations again on such a great career. And thank you for this conversation. Yep. It really was a pleasure to have you get to practice or the game or whatever's going on. And have a good time. All the best to you and your family.
Hey, thanks, guys. All the best. Have a great night.